हेलो, दिस इज़ स्वप्निल ममानी, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर, आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, महिला महाविद्यालय तासगांव। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। C++ ऑपरेटर्स। ऑपरेटर्स आर यूज्ड टू परफॉर्म ऑपरेशंस ऑन वेरिएबल्स एंड वैल्यूज। इन द एग्जांपल बिलो वी यूज द प्लस ऑपरेटर टू ऐड टुगेदर टू वैल्यूज। एग्जांपल इज इंटीजर एक्स equal to 100 plus 50. Although the plus operator is often used to add together two values, like in the example above, it can also be used to add together a variable and a value, or a variable and another value. For example, integer sum 1 equal to 100 plus 50. There is a two values 100 and 50. Second example, integer sum 2 equal to sum 1 plus 250. There is a sum 1 is a variable and 250 is the value. Third example, integer sum 3 equal to sum 2 plus sum 2. There is a two variables we have used here. C++ divides the operators into the following groups. First, arithmetic operators. Second, assignment operators. Third, comparison operators. Fourth, logical operators. And last five, bitwise operators. Let's see the arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators are used to perform common mathematical operations. First operator is plus. Name, addition. It adds together two values. For example, x plus y. Operator minus. Name, subtraction. It subtracts one value from another. For example, x minus y. Operator into. Name, multiplication. It multiplies two values. For example, x into y. Operator division. Name, dividing. It divides one value by another. For example, x divided by y. Operator percent. Name, modulus. It returns the division remainder. For example, x percent y. Operator double plus means plus plus. Name, increment. It increases the value of a variable by 1. For example, plus plus x or x plus plus. Operator minus minus. Name, decrement. It decreases the value of a variable by 1. For example, minus minus x or x minus minus. C++ assignment operators. Assignment operators are used to assign values to variables, that is equal. In the example below, we use the assignment operator equal to assign the value 10 to a variable called x. Example is integer x equal to 10. The addition assignment operator means plus equal to adds a value to a variable. For example, integer x equal to 10, next line is x plus equal to 5. It means x equal to x plus 5. A list of all assignment operators like plus equal to, there is a minus equal to, into equal to, divide by equal to, percent equal to, etc. Now let us see comparison operators. Comparison operators are used to compare two values. Note here, the return value of comparison operator is either true means 1 or false means 0. In the below example, we use the greater than operator to find out 5 is greater than 3. Example is integer x equal to 5, integer y equal to 3, cout insertion operator in bracket x greater than y semicolon. it returns 1 true because 5 is greater than 3. Like that, there is a list of all comparison operators. Double equal to sign operator, name equal to, it always with if conditions. Example, if x equal to equal to y, it is used to check x with y. Operator explanation mark equal to, that name is not equal. Example, x not equal to y. Operator greater than. Example, x greater than y. Operator less than. Example, x less than y. Operator greater than equal to. Example, x greater than equal to y. Operator less than equal to. Example, x less than equal to y. C++ logical operators. Logical operators are used to determine the logic between variables or values. Operator double AND, name logical AND. It returns the true if both statements are true. Example, x less than 5, double AND, x less than 10. Operator OR, that's name is logical OR. It returns true if one of the statement is true. For example, x less than 5 or x less than 4. Operator NOT, name logical NOT. It reverses the result. Returns false if the result is true. For example, NOT in bracket x less than 5, double AND x less than 10. Now we are going to learn C++ control structure. There are some usual logical conditions from mathematics like less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal to. Use this condition to perform different actions for different decisions. C++ has the following conditional statements. Use if to specify a block of code to be executed if a specified condition is true. Use else to specify a block of code to be executed if the same condition is false. Use else if to specify a new condition to test if the first condition is false. Use switch to specify many alternative blocks of code to be executed. Now see the if statement. Use the if statement to specify a block of C++ code to be executed if a condition is true. Syntax, if in bracket condition, in opening and closing curly, there is a block of code to be executed if the condition is true. Note that if is in lowercase letter. Uppercase letters if will generate an error. In the below example, we test two values to find out if 20 is greater than 18. If the condition is true, print some text. If in bracket 20 is greater than 18, in curly bracket see out 20 is greater than 18. In this example, output is 20 is greater than 18. We can also test variables such as integer x equal to 20, integer y equal to 18. If x greater than y, see out x is greater than y. In this example, x is 20 and y is 18. So x is greater than y. Output is x is greater than y. C++ else, the else statement. Use the else statement to specify a block of code to be executed if the condition is false. Syntax, if in bracket condition in opening curly block of code to be executed if the condition is true, close curly else opening curly block of codes to be executed if the condition is false, close curly. For example, integer time equal to 20, if time is less than 18, cout good day, else cout good evening. In this example, the output is good evening because time is not less than 18. C++ else if. The else if statement use the else if statement to specify a new condition if the first condition is false. Syntax if condition 1 opening curly block of code to be executed if condition is true, close curly else if condition 2 open curly block of code to be executed if the condition 1 is false and condition 2 is true, close curly else open curly block of code to be executed if the condition 1 is false and condition 2 is false. Let's see the example here. Integer time equal to 22. If time is less than 10, cout good morning. Else if time is less than 20, cout good day. Else cout good evening. The explanation of this is time 22 is greater than 10. So the first condition is false. The next condition, the else if statement is also false. So we move on the else condition. Since condition 1 and condition 2 is both false, then print the screen good evening. However, if the time was 14, our program would be print good day. C++ shorthand if else. There are also shorthand if else which is known as ternary operator because it consists of three operands. It can be used to replace multiple lines of code with a single line. It is often used to replace simple if statements. Syntax variable equal to condition question mark expression true colon expression false semicolon. Now see the below program. Integer time equal to 20. If time less than 18, cout good day. Else cout good evening. Instead of this, we can write integer time equal to 20 string result equal to in bracket time less than 18 question mark good day colon good evening semicolon cout result. Now turn to last point of this lecture, that is C++ switch statements. Use the switch statement to select one of many code blocks to be executed. Syntax switch in bracket expression in open curly case x colon after colon there is a code block, then break statements case y colon after colon code block then break statements. X and y are the variables. We can use any name of variables or letter also. Last statement is default colon. There is a default block. The break keyword, it breaks out of the switch block. This will stop the execution of more code and case testing inside the block. When a match is found and the job is done, it's time for a break. there is no need for more testing. A break can save a lot of execution time because it ignores the execution of all the rest of code in the switch block. The default keyword specifies some code to run if there is no case of match. For example, integer day equal to 4, switch day, case 6, cout today is Saturday, break, case 7, cout today is Sunday, break. Default case is looking forward to the weekend. But in this example, the day equal to 4, so there is no matching case. So output of this program is looking forward to the weekend. Either this, if case is 6, there is output is today is a Saturday. To get the more videos of this series, please like, share and subscribe. And please do not forget to press the bell icon to view latest videos. Thank you.